You need to push the button.
Is it on?
No.
Hey, Troy, can you turn me up? On the handheld mic? Until that happens. Hello, Instagram. Welcome to Friday Night Youth. So before we get started tonight, I have a prize for you guys. All right, now. Okay, so raise your hand. Okay, raise your hand if you like In-N-Out Burger. Everybody. Okay, I'm gonna need your help with this.
Okay.
Because, yeah, you pick. Anyways. Okay, so on Monday night, we do our Monday night streams. I'm gonna give the person who gives this right will get a, I think there's $5 on here. And I don't want to hear you guys say that's not a lot of money because $5 at In-N-Out can get you a burger. Okay? So there's $5 on here, and I've had this since Christmas because I wanted to get it to you guys. So, but I'm just not going to hand it to y'all. If you answer this question right, the person who does that will get it in. Is it on yet? No? Yes, no? Maybe so? The person who gets it right will give $5 to In-N-Out Burger. And no, I did not use this. The PIN number is not scratched off yet. Okay? It's untapped. Hey. Okay, so on Monday night, we do our Instagram streams at 7 o'clock. Who can tell me what was taught on Monday night?
Nobody.
Ooh.
I can't.
Then we post them on YouTube, so they're available on YouTube.
Dang, y'all just missed out on having $5.
Nope.
I want you guys to go back and watch it.
Jesus.
It's
always there.
It's always about Jesus.
No, you had to give specifics.
Okay, so I'm gonna keep this.
Nope.
In my wallet. I'm going to keep this in my wallet. Next week, possibly, you never know when I'm going to ask you this question again. But if you guys can give me the answer to what we taught on a Monday, you'll get $5 stickers. And on a separate note, watch the streams. There's some good stuff on there, guys. Just not doing that just to hear ourselves talk. We're doing it for you guys. And for those of you who don't have Instagram, we do put it on YouTube. And I know sometimes I forget to put it on there, but the messages are on YouTube. If you don't know what our YouTube name is, it's our name, Rise Up Youth Ministry. Okay? All right.
No excuses.
No excuses. Oh, yes, I'm on. No excuses.
Okay, and another note before we get started. So I want to apologize to you guys in person in front of you guys. I made a mistake today. It was a really bad mistake, and I had to apologize to Maribel about it. So I was in charge of packing dinner tonight, and I kind of messed up and forgot an item. This item Maribel has been craving because she is pregnant, and I messed up, and I did not give her the beans that she wanted. Yes, she wants beans. She wanted beans.
Pinto.
Ooh. I like black beans.
Huh?
Yeah, so that's a long story, but I just forgot. So I'm sorry.
That was his corny way of telling you guys.
That was my corny way of saying we're having a baby.
You guys have known.
That's not all right,
all right. So,
you knew.
Everybody's talking.
Sorry. It's your fault. You started it off with that.
Whatever.
All right, so tonight we are going to be continuing to talk about I am the salt of the earth. Now, yes.
Okay, so on a side note, I was reading one of my books on Wattpad, and as we were talking about salt, one of my books brings up, it said something about, it was one of my animes with a side of salt.
Oh. Wow.
Okay, so this is going to be the last day that we talk about salt, because next week is our activity night, and then next month we're moving on to a new lesson. But this is a really, really, really important topic that we're talking about, and tonight's lesson is not going to be terribly long, because we have something special that we want to do after the message. So who can tell me what you guys learned last week? Cody.
We learned about how the salt of the earth is going to be in our life.
Okay.
We are the salt of the earth.
We are the salt of the earth. Zion.
Something about spreading the good news.
That's something really about good. Spreading the good news. Something about spreading the good news. Yeah, that's really good. Adessa.
We're the salt of the earth. We make the earth taste good too.
Yes. Yes. All of these are really, really great answers. Anybody else? Anybody else want to add to that? Yes.
Well, it's not last week. It's kind of is. Basically, we were learning about that you are the salt of the earth. So if you share the salt, you are sharing God's love.
Yeah, sharing the gospel. Yes, that's good. Sharing the gospel is sharing God's love.
Salt can be sweet
if you salt it the right way. You know. Last week, Pastor Tony was talking about oatmeal and how if you put a little salt in it, then it makes the flavors jump. EJ.
We learned that salty metal, it enhances stuff, when you put it on food, it enhances the flavor.
Yep. So. Yep. Good. Good. Last one.
Salt. Salt.
Yeah, yeah, that's also another one that we learned. Salt was used as currency. Okay, no, that was the last one. I gotta be a man of my word. Huh? If it's not important, I'm not even gonna call on you again tonight. Okay, Zion.
So, you see, there was basically told a story where there was he was talking to Jesus or God, and he was asking him if there was 40 persons.
Sodom and Gomorrah.
Yeah.
And then he kept going down and went down to 10.
Right.
And then he asked if there were 10 persons in the city, but he destroyed it, and God said no.
Wow. Now, why did Pastor Tony give us that example? Adassa, do you know?
Because the little salt can make the difference in the city. So, and a little bit of salt can make the difference in the city.
Yeah. So, what was that first thing you said? A little salt can make a difference in the city. So, us, the church, we are the salt of the earth. We are making a difference in the world because we are making the world taste good to the Lord because we are spreading the gospel. We are winning souls for Jesus. And that in itself is what I'm going to focus on talking about a little tonight. Because I want to be blunt, I want to ask you guys a question. I want you guys to be completely raw and honest with me. Okay? Be honest. Because I'm going to be honest right back with you. You guys ready? If you... Come here, Cody. Okay. I'm walking down the street. Cody doesn't know me. I know he knows me, but Cody does, in this instance, he does not know me. And God puts it on his heart to tell me God puts on Cody's heart to tell me about God, to share the gospel with me. And I'm walking, and now Cody sees me, we make eye contact, I say hi, he says hi back to me. Be honest. If you're right here and you're going to have the opportunity to share the gospel with another person, are you scared? Be honest. Raise your hand if you're scared.
A little bit.
You got both the youth pastors saying, yes, I'm scared. You got a leader up there saying, yes, I'm scared. It's a scary thing. You start thinking about, man, how should I present it to this person?
Because he gets mad.
Yeah, what if he gets mad? What if he yells at me? What if he rejects me? What do I even say?
What if he laughs?
What if he laughs at me? There's all these things that go in our head. And then sometimes we like to overcompensate. You guys know what that means, overcompensate? It means overdo it.
You're doing the most.
Doing the most. You do the most and to the point where the person just like, you're weird, leave me alone. We miss an opportunity. Look, there are times where I get scared. Sharing the gospel can be a really scary thing at that time. It really can. And that begs a question. I want you guys to be completely honest with me again. We're just being honest with each other right now. Why is this still on my face? Anyways, do you guys know how to share the gospel? Raise your hand if you know how to do that. Okay. Well, tonight, we're going to learn. Because sharing the gospel, it's a beautiful thing. And I want to be clear, tonight is not about me charging you guys and telling you guys, like, look, you're going to go share the gospel. Or else next week, you ain't come to youth group if you ain't sharing. I'm being serious. No, that's not what tonight's about. We just want to make sure that you guys know that just because you guys are teens, you guys hear us say this so much, I feel like a broken record. Just because you guys are teens, between the ages of 10 and 17, does not matter. You guys have the light of the world in you. You are the salt of the earth. You are capable of sharing Jesus with somebody. And what is the gospel? The gospel is simply this. Jesus came down here, God in the flesh, walked with us, talked with us, healed us, did miracles. He hung on the cross for us, took our sins, because if he didn't do that, none of us would be going to heaven. If he didn't take our sins, none of us would be going to heaven. But he did. He took every single thing, put it on himself, hung on that cross and died for us so that we can have a relationship with the Father, have eternal life, if we repent of our sins and all that. And the greatest thing about this is Jesus rose on the third day. So we don't just have somebody who just died for us. We have somebody who not only died for us, but he came back alive and is over everything. He's over us right now. He's guiding us. He has mercy. He has grace on us. He's showing us what to do. He's blessing us. There's a bunch of things Jesus is doing for us right now. That's the gospel. And the thing is, it's like, well, really scared to share that with somebody because I will never stand up here and talk to you guys. I don't want you guys to think that I got everything right. I don't want you guys to look at me and think, KK knows what he's doing 100% of the time. He's not scared of nothing. He's just too cool for school. No, I'm definitely not too cool for school. I'm definitely scared a lot of times. I definitely don't know what I'm doing sometimes. One weakness that I have is that I don't want confrontation and I don't want to be hated, which stops me sometimes from sharing the gospel. Because sometimes, I'm going to be honest, people don't want to hear about Jesus. They don't want to hear it. They're going to reject it. But that's not on us. We are supposed to just share it with them. What they do with it is what they do with it. That's not on us. So there's some scriptures. It's one passage, I'm sorry, that Maribel and I were reading the other night because we're just looking at each other like we have no idea what we're going to minister on tonight. And then God gave us this. Now, it's by scripture, so I want you guys to follow along with me, okay? Because this is going to help you. It's 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 1 through 5. And it says this, Christian brothers and sisters, and this is Paul talking, okay? Christian brothers and sisters, when I came to you, I did not preach the secrets of God with big sounding words or make it sound as if I was so wise. I made up my mind that while I was with you, I would speak nothing except Jesus Christ and of his death on the cross. When I was with you, I was weak. I was afraid, and I shook. What I had to say when I preached was not in big-sounding words of man's wisdom, but it was given in the power of the Holy Spirit. In this way, you do not have faith in Christ because of the wisdom of men. You have faith in Christ because of the power of God. Now, there is a whole bunch of stuff in it. But the key thing that I want you guys to focus on, what I just read to you guys, is that Paul was one of the greatest church leaders we have ever had. It's not debatable. He was awesome. He made mistakes, but he was awesome. Church wouldn't be here today if he wasn't a part of the early church. That's how important Paul was. Now, Paul, another awesome thing about Paul, most of the books in the Bible in the New Testament were written by Paul. So when you guys open up the Bible and you guys are reading in the New Testament, majority of those, Paul wrote those. He's important. And for him to say, and I'm paraphrasing here, when I preach the gospel to you, Christine, I didn't use big words. I wasn't trying to sound all high and mighty. I wasn't trying to be this perfect person. I just told you who Jesus Christ was and what he did for us on the cross. That's the gospel, guys. You don't need to have big words. You don't need to be 30 years old to do this. You don't need to be the greatest thing since sliced bread. I'm serious. God did not call the most wisest person. God called you guys. God did not call the most prettiest person. He called you guys. God did not call the richest person. He called you guys. You guys are capable. You're absolutely capable of doing this. I have confidence in you guys. And you want to know why I have confidence in you guys? Because of this. I was looking at an article. Hold on. I was looking at an article about ways that teens can share the gospel. I got inspired because when I was looking at it, I was like, you know what? I know our teens can do this. They've already done it. I know you guys have. And it's simple. Look, let's take a look at some of these. One of them says, invite neighbors. Okay, invite neighbors to your home Bible study and love them. And love them. Okay, so I don't know if you guys have exactly done that, but what I can say is that you guys have invited people to church. You guys have invited people to youth group. You got somebody new. Because he was invited to youth group. And yes, Jeremiah, I'm talking about you. All eyes on you, bro. I know that Hadassah has invited some of her friends to youth group. I don't exactly know if any of them are following Jesus, but she invited them.
I invited this one.
Yeah, Kaylin. Jaden is here because of you. Daniel, Christine, how many friends have you guys invited to church?
A lot.
Yeah. Now, I mean, you don't have to answer this. It's just a question that I'm just throwing out to the group. When you guys invite people, sometimes they're not saved, sometimes they are. Sometimes they're not following Jesus, sometimes they are. But when you come to youth group, when you come to church on Sundays, we're spreading the gospel. We're talking about Jesus, and we're leaving it to new people if they want to accept it or not. That's a really easy way to share the gospel. Invite somebody to church. Who cares if somebody says, nah, I'm good? It's not on you. You did it. You asked. It's like this. Do you have a card on you? A church card?
Oh.
Yeah.
Maybe?
Yeah, I think I do.
So, I'm going to give you guys an example on something. Cool. So, this is one of our church cards. Alright? Now, we're in the process of making one specifically for a youth group. So, that's a work in progress. But, today, I was with some of the other people who come to church today. We went to a place that had a shooting, and somebody lost their life. And the reason we were there with the cops was to just minister to the people in the surrounding area. And then one of the things that we did was when we were talking to the people, we knocked on the door, they opened it. We asked them if they wanted prayer, which is another thing that you can ask people. We asked them if they wanted prayer, and then we gave them a card. This is a way of sharing with people, because now they have a way to get in contact with us. Now, I'll be honest, some people looked at me like I was a buffoon. I got rejected. This is like, they took the card like, thanks. I'm like, okay, well, have a good day. Look, guys, it's gonna happen. Some people are gonna reject us. Some people are gonna say, I don't want. And we're human, and sometimes this stuff affects us, but it's not supposed to. Like, it, sometimes it affects us, but you just keep it moving because you guys are planting seeds, all right? Another way to share the gospel is just, you know, just in a conversation that you guys are having with somebody, if there's a way that you can bring up God, not force it, but if there's a way you can bring up God in the conversation, bring them up.
Mm-hmm.
Let people know.
Testimony.
Let them know your testimony. Let them know, yeah. Let them know that Jesus loves them and that you're praying for them. That's really powerful when you say you're praying for somebody. And not just saying, yeah, I'll keep you in prayer, but no, actually doing it. That's where the power is at. Okay? This stuff is important. And I'm completely confident that you guys can do this. Now, if you guys want, I can make copies of this paper on ways to share the gospel. If you want it, I'll go make copies and I'll give it to you guys before you leave. If you're interested in that, come see me afterwards, okay? Please.
Or raise your hand, right?
Or, yeah, raise your hand if you would like me to make you a copy of that. Girls? Okay. Because you guys have every opportunity to do it. A lot of you guys are on social media. That's a really easy way to do it. And yeah, some people are going to be like, not following this person no more. Can't stand them. Hey, you're just doing what God has called you to do. And lastly, but not least, before we end tonight, we start on our next thing. When you are sharing the good news to somebody, whether they say, hey, tell me more, or how can I be saved, or they say, I'm good, I don't want it. It's not us. We don't save anybody. Have you guys heard that before? We're not the ones who to save. We're just planting the seed. We give them the good news. Now, if they tell you when you're sharing the good news to them and saying, hey, Jesus loves you, he died for you, he wants to have a relationship with you, the Holy Spirit is trying to work. And if they say, hey, tell me more, how can I do that? Praise God. But if not, you planted a seed. Never feel ashamed. Never feel bad about telling somebody about Jesus. And I'll be quiet after this, but I had a coworker. I think this was last week. He came up to me. He asked for prayer. Now, my job knows that I'm a Christian. very vocal about it. So I prayed for him, but I know that there was a bunch of people that were walking by us. About 10 minutes later, I had another coworker come up to me and he said, "Hey man, I didn't want to bother you while you were praying, but I really felt this, like in the spot that you were praying, I really felt like, I forget the word that he used, but I really felt God's presence." Now, I don't know if this gentleman is following the Lord or if he knows a lot about the Lord, but he said that. Now, that would have been a really easy way for me to share with him. But you guys want to know what KK did? "Oh, yeah, man, that's cool. God's presence is an awesome thing. All right, I got to go to work." Missed opportunity. Missed opportunity. So, and I regretted that. But God will give you opportunities to share. Especially if you wake up in the morning and was like, "Lord, I pray that I have an opportunity to minister to somebody." Sure. So God goes, "Ooh, I got you. I got you." So if you guys take anything from tonight, you are the salt, you are the light. You have the capabilities of spreading the gospel. You're not too young. You can do it.
Amen.
You can do it. And if I have a paper of ways that you can, resources. And I guess we can ask that later. So that's the big thing that I wanted to talk to you guys about tonight. We, as promised, we have something really cool that we're going to do. We have our very own Daniel and Christine Sonoy. They're going to be doing worship with us tonight.
Woo!
So.
Can I stay on here since?
Huh?
I said, can I stay on here since?
Oh, yeah, you know what? You guys are going to be a part of this. Because it's Daniel and Christine, so yeah. All right, without further ado, dun dun dun, there's some noise.
Please stand up so we can... All right, let's... Zion, come on, we're doing praise and worship. We're worshiping the Lord.
Okay, check, 1, 2.
Okay, so this song is called "I Give You My Heart," and it's an awesome song. So we're just gonna worship the Lord.
What?
Okay, all right, here we go.
This is my desire to honor you, Lord, with all my heart, I worship you. Yeah.
Thank you.
say bye to her.
Bye!
Bye!
Bye.
Bye.
Okay, I ended the